suppose you are wondering what's been going on, haven't you?
Oh, no. Seems typical to me. But I will admit that the sight of that chainsaw on the nightstand has my curiosity piqued.
Very explosive people, politicians and detectives and judges and rock stars. And we were trained for like 3 weeks in SNM because, I mean, these guys were in a real serious shit, from speed enemas to like, you know, oh, fucking.
There's a lot of enemas.
You know,
yeah.
All kinds of stuff. And we, you know, piercings, and we tie them up and hang them upside down. We had a throne that we would sit down and pee on a guy's face.
Nice.
And then we had one client that I didn't do this, but some of the girls would pay extra to defecate into a bag, and we had a guy that would just kind of crawl and roll around in this bag.
Okay.
Very odd. We had a guy that used to hang up in the elevator. And on the weight in the elevator, the freight elevator, so when we went up and down, he would just be hung upside down. Almost forgot about it, almost killed poor bastard. I mean, but it was a great place. It was a great training for all kinds of clinical S&M stuff. Know where to hit people, how to hit them, how far to stick with certain size things up certain places, what to pierce where, what not to pierce these things.
Uh-huh.
So when I made this movie, I was like, I'll do it.
Cool.
I can do this.
I was wondering, like, the director's known kind of controversial.
Yeah.
Pretty controversial.
He was an asshole. But we had a great time.
Oh, cool. Awesome. Yeah, if any other stories you got with that movie, I'd love to hear them.
The Taming of Rebecca.
I mean,
that's about
George Payne, is he is?
George Payne. Was a really good friend of mine.
Cool.
I love George. I think he's still around in New York.
I actually saw a...
Why are there flies?
I don't know. I don't...
Is it something? Is it my hairspray?
It might be.
Am I dying?
I saw a YouTube video of him doing like senior citizen workouts.
Pardon me?
George Payne was doing like senior citizen workouts.
Yeah, he was always in really great shape, and he was always good. Just one of those great people. I mean, we always used to get loaded back then, and George and I used to get loaded together all the time and like stay up all night and go to the set.
Awesome.
This was one of the first movies I ever did.
That movie's awesome.
Yeah, it's a great movie.
Yeah.
Is Ronnie in this too?
No. Robert Kerman is in that with you.
Robert Kerman.
Yeah. Or, well, R. Balla, whatever. Alias is in
the biggest fucking hypochondriac.
Really? Man, he's supposed to, like... I was supposed to meet him twice.
He had something back then. And that was before, like, even herpes. I mean, it was like, you don't have anything. Nothing to get. We got fucking measles, for Christ's sake.
Yeah, that's an awesome picture, too, on the cover. Was that taken...
No, this was a movie shot.
Oh, okay.
It was on the set.
Okay, cool. Yeah, that's awesome. That'd be a sweet poster.
I was playing somebody older, and they used to... Whenever you play somebody older, they always used to spray that goofy blue-gray shit in your hair.
Wow, you look awesome, though. Either way, you always look awesome. So.
Thank you. I try.
Oh, do you?
I try. I still work out.
Okay.
This looks like a. This is like a real archive.
I got more than this. Just leave me, but. This is actually really good.
What is that, beta?
Yeah, it's a beta.
Holy shit.
This was really early on.
Yeah, you were super young in that.
I think this was my first movie. I think this is one of my first movies.
You looked younger than Enjoy.
I remember this movie. Susan McVeigh lived on the 59th Street Boat Race, and Bobby Astor was a jazz drummer. And it was my first movie, and I was sitting on Bobby Astor, and I was fucking him. And I remember the director going, okay, say something dirty. And I was like a Catholic school girl. I was like barely 18. I was like, like, cut, cut, cut. This is boring. I'm not coming inside. I'm gonna come outside. So I couldn't, I mean, with my Catholic mind, I'm like, I said, oh baby, come in my hand. And I hopped off. And I put my... And I lived on Downing Street, New York, and there was a little park on the end. And my friends actually put graffiti on it, come in my hand, on one of the little tiles. So it became known as Come in My Hand Park rather than Downing Street Park. But I soon learned how to speak dirty. Soon thereafter.
Did you do like a record? Did you do like an LP record?
I did. I did a couple LP records. I did Talk Dirty to Me, Sharon Mitchell. And then I did...
Is that seriously you talking dirty over disco?
Yeah.
Awesome. I
want
that.
Then I did a... from Polydor, I did a few salsa records.
Man. Yeah, I've been trying to find that stuff.
They're really hard
can't
to find.
It.
Yeah.
I'm sure you will.
I'll find it eventually. Yeah, it's awesome. Have you seen that movie?
Yeah,
so super young.
Yeah, wow, that's an oldie but a goodie.
Beta.
Yeah, I got a couple more things too. So.
Oh, Joe.
Wow.
Great guy.
Yeah, too bad he's.
I know.
Not here anymore.
Which is one of those, like, so too artistic for his own good, you know?
Awesome. I got a couple more.
No worries.
Your collection?
Oh, I know.
Swedish erotica.
Everything.
Dude, I have like...
This, you know, you couldn't work for them unless you had the signature scarf, the garter belt, and stockings. That was their... God, I almost have the same shoe.
Their style.
But no, that was their signature thing, was the scarf.
Huh.
If you'll ever notice any other Swedish erotica, every woman has the scarf, the garter belt, the stockings, and the high heels.
I was going to say, if you open up that top flap, there's a pamphlet in there, too. Open it. There's a pamphlet that has a bunch of other...
Whose dick am I sitting on? Oh my god, PT! I should have known that. I should have recognized that. This is the San Francisco days.
I was going to ask you, was there a difference between working in New York compared to San Francisco?
Well, we all did loops to support ourselves back then, and these were loops. These were done, they were shot in 90 minutes, and they only paid like, $500,
$800.
Oh. It was like on a Saturday morning, everybody used to get together and like, watch a football game and like take turns fucking each other and make a little extra cash. But, the biggest difference between New York and when everything moved to California was when video.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. New York was all about film and mobs.
Oh.
The mob, and then everybody kind of moved out. And the business probably expanded by a good 100%. I mean, there were probably about 30 of us that worked in New York in the 70s, and then it went to 300, and then it went to...
What area did you like better? New York or...
I like New York, because that's kind of where I met all my friends, who I still have.
Okay, that's cool. Huh? Oh, I don't know. Some said that's like a...
I got a question. There's rumor that the Taming of Rebecca was in Jeffrey Dahmer's VCR when they arrested him. Do you know anything about this?
Not, but I'm honored. I mean, such an incredibly sick mind. Wow. To have such great taste.
I was going to say.
It's almost 100% fact, too. They found that.
Wow. Yeah, but in another serial killer,
I don't want to take any credit for starting up.
Yeah, this is like one of my all-time favorite movies, Times Square.
Oh yeah.
And you were in the club scene.
Yeah, I was just an extra in that.
It was awesome,
wasn't I? But it was a great cutaway. I was wearing
that. Yeah. Any stories about working on that one? Nice. Yes.
We worked at night, which I really liked.
How long were you there on the set? To
probably 3 or 4 days.
Just to do that little.
Oh
that
yeah.
Little
yeah. That's a lot awesome. Of extra work back then. Extra work, a lot of good work.
All right, sweet. Well, this is all I'm gonna get right now, so.
Okay. You're done?
I brought more, but
she's gonna make me
seriously.
Look a complete amateur. My collection's up.
Hold on a second, let me pay her first.
Oh, good point.
Oh my god.
How much time is it?
It's 140.
Here, let me put your stuff away here.
It's great, fantastic stuff.
Really great stuff. Wow.
Yeah, you just need me to make it.
It's
a lot of competition.
Yeah, really.
We're just happy to see you.
Can I get a picture with you as well?
Sure.
You don't charge that?
No.
No.
Sweet. That's cool. I just missed meeting you. I'm super happy. That's like the... obviously. Okay. Now it's their turn.
All right.
Oh, no, my gosh.
Now that Lori's made me look like a fool.
What do we have?
Oh,
one
water power!
Favorites.
Somebody kept asking me today, are you ever ashamed of doing that? I said, I'm never ashamed of anything I ever did. I wouldn't have done it. Why do you do something you're going to be ashamed of? I mean, in the 80s, money was way too easy to come by. So.
Yeah. Actually, you get the inside. Inside. Pull this right
out. He's new at this.
This is my first convention.
And your name?
Scott.
Oh, you want to do it on the front? Scott?
Actually, I wanted it on the cover. That's not a big deal.
How can I make this work? I know, but now that I fucked this up,
that's what she's gonna do.
It's $20. $20.
Right now. I don't do business. Sign and talk of shit. Great stuff, though.
Yeah, this is fun.
Well, it's very nice meeting you.
You
still look as lovely as ever.
Definitely. Yeah. No way. Are you going to get a picture with her, Scott?
Can I get a picture?
See, he's still learning.
No, you know. Let me see. We'll check it out. I don't know.
I think you look a little cross-eyed at this guy.
I don't think he can.
But since you're in my arms already, I'll get
it. They use them.
Is your battery
power out?
It's stuck on your picture, Scott. Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh.
Oh, wait, no, I blinked. Fuck, you have to take it again. I'm sorry. No, they are not.
Let's
they
see.
So are not. Looks like I'm on the nod, for Christ's sake. We can't have that. We have too many of those old movies.
Morning.
Penis.
Okay. I just talked him into getting something else.
Awesome. Thank you. Hi, Warriors, my bark.
Hey, I'll do that. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, this is one of my favorite. This movie called The Lobe Warriors.
Laura, you're going to have to follow me around.
I know. Well, okay, I'll take this back into my room and
to like to Guillermo, which is the hottest place in the Northern Hemisphere.
I'm super happy. Super.
But they wrote these down with like all this
stuff. Nope.
And they were like windshields.
Now I got these. I figured I'd get this over.
So what do I have to do? Pull the covers out?
Yeah, and make sure you have that facing up because, you know, that's cool though. You got double signature.
Did you ever have to get sand out of your juice?
Ooh, I'm burning up.
Keep it up. Thank you,
know
you so
what
much.
I mean.
You gotta get a picture, Danny?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, pay. Pay it.
Okay, here's the chocolate. How do you guys just keep getting taller and taller? The lighting in here does suck.
Yeah, that's
what makes everybody look like they have bags under their
eyes. Hey, you want another take?
Good?
Good?
Yeah, looks good.
Does it? I can't see it.
It doesn't matter. Just meeting her is.
Thank you.
I think Jesse's next.
Oh,
Jesse's
come on, Jess.
Jesse wants to get something signed.
We got a kamikaze horse too. Oh my god.
Yeah.
This is a classic.
Can you make that one to me?
G-E-S-S-E.
Alright.
This is awesome. Okay. Whew. Best 20 minutes ever on video.
I absolutely can't.
Can you help me put this stuff in?
I'm gonna put thanks for last night, Jess. No one will know.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Cinema Wasteland 22. Just like to remind you, at 8 o'clock in about a half an hour, the first panel of the evening in Movie and Guest Room 1 after Hollywood Chainsaw Huggers is our Hollywood Chainsaw Hugger
panel.
Hey, I want to be back later.
Michelle Bauer and Sunday. It's 8 o'clock to after Hollywood Chainsaw Huggers. Don't miss the first panel of the night.
Let's take a picture. I just want to hear from her for thing up here. I'm holding up the first movie, that for the blue. Yeah, you can be in it too.
Oh, I don't want to want it. I just want to take
pictures. Oh, shut up.
Wait, hold on.
Did you want anything else?
I just think that's great.
This is a good stuff. Tryout.
Yeah.
There we go.
I feel like I'm looking at my daughter's
That'd be fun. That's great. Great stuff.
Yeah, I'm gonna take a walk.
Thank you.
Awesome. That was fun.
Yeah, Nice. That's freaking awesome. Yeah, I might be back Sunday to see you again. Yeah, come back. Okay, cool.
held up for years.
I'm glad somebody appreciates my Lay's dill pickle chips.
When I'm hungry, I reach for a Lay's potato chip. It's pickle rippin'. Do us a flavor. Oh, that's a word pun. You guys are fucking smart.
I'm glad you like those, seriously. I thought.
No filming?
Yeah.
I thought it was fun. I can keep going. I can ad-lib the fuck out of this. You can create the next potato chip flavor. You should send them something really, like, fucking weird, like Jindu.
Yeah, Jindu.
Uh-huh.
Jindu.
That's our drink. We mix Mountain Dew and gin. We call it Jindu. It sounds really Japanese.
But you just like don't want... You did.
Yep. They pushed him around for too long. Jindu. In Technicolor. Something like that.
Jin don't. Jin do or Jin don't?
Get in or get out. No Nintendo 64. It was that weird time where they had to put 64 at the end of every game ever, and it was really stupid. Super Mario 64, DK 64. It's like, it's 64 bits, we get it. You can stop now.
You're so angry.
Me never. Sarcasm. I'm gonna James Hetfield a song. Requests, anybody. Pick a song. Something I would know.
Something by Annie Lennox.
By Annie Lennox? A sweet dream right of this. It sounds like the middle of Enter Sandman. You know, hush little baby, don't say it. There. I'm Metallica'd Annie Lennox.
Awesome.
Any other requests? Anybody? Awesome. Anybody in the room? You, sir? You, ma'am? Nothing else?
Nothing else? Seriously? Crazy Train.
Crazy Train? Oh, God. Crazy! That's how it goes. You betcha.
Well, Lady Gaga, then.
Lady Gaga?
Yeah, Bad Romance.
Oh, God. I don't know if I know the lyrics besides the ooh la na. It's a bad romance. What's her other fucking song about the telephone? Stop calling now. I don't want to talk anymore.
Yeah, there you go. Yes. Excellent. I got that.
It's kind of on your fanny.
Kind of.
You know, not really.
Are you recording this?
Yeah. Yes, I am. I have to. You know, it's like my job.
Why? Because it's a fanny pack? You don't see those much?
Yep.
Hey, at least it's the North Face.
Yeah.
It's a fanny pack. His shoes are slick, though.
Oh, man. Are those actually comfortable?
Yeah, actually they are. You know, the shoes make the outfit.
You're so unique.
I think the Celine Dion shirt's the best, though.
Yeah.
Did you actually go to the concert?
No, actually, I bought it at Goodwill. I took a shortcut.
Hopefully we weren't supposed to wait for, like, Scott and Danny. Hopefully they just come over.
I hope I get a job at Chipolte, because I hate Applebee's.
Oh, is that where you work now?
I hate Applebee's. I hate them.
Are you not in? Bad customers or just bad company?
Go out to Strongsville?
Yeah. I have friends out in Brunswick.
Oh!
I did.
That was public.
I got that. Did you get that?
Uh-huh. Did you tear your arm off?
I did. I don't know. This is why I don't know.
Did you get his Celine Dion shirt? His whole outfit.
I don't know, that's his style.
I like it.
He's not stuck in this.
Yeah.
But
stuck in the
70s.
Right. Yeah, sweet. Alright. Oh! Hey, Danny! We're over here!
Thank you.
That's what we're all getting. I just told him, like, I hope you guys know to come here. Get up here!
VIP.
Oh my god!
Awesome.
Are you sure they ain't gonna
put things on the camera? Yeah.
Nikon.
Miss me.
Like how you shoved me?
Stay back and claim it. You're an asshole just holding you.
I don't have any more money in my checking account.
You need money?
Yeah. You want brown rice or
what? Shut up.
Why is that funny? I don't get it.
I don't know either. I don't know. He always needs money.
Did you see how many 20s he pulled out in your hotel room?
Tomatoes.
Huh?
He pulled out a bunch of 20s in his hotel room.
Is that one of them?
Yeah.
Medium?
Yeah, it's medium.
No, cheap guys.
See, it's not vital information.
Don't.
Why is she recording me?
Am I recording? Is that what's happening here? Are they here?
I want to go on the pirate ship.
Yep, there they are. I can't believe we found them.
Let's go now.
Yeah. You beat him.
Everyone takes it.
His finger was on the button when he like needed.
This dude go crazy by the fucking world.
It's better be wearing a condom. It's dirty as fuck.
Come on, elevator.
Yes.
Razor.
I knew it was coming.
We spice it up.
Biffs off.
Then I'm out like a boner in sweatpants. Jiggling my ass like Jagger. What was that with that?
Bringing herpes back, yo.
I fucked a monkey once or twice.
I fucked a monkey.
Why'd you do it?
Dead
or vice versa.
He's half man, half bear, half pig.
That's the third.
Did Mark go home?
Yeah. He's supposed to come back in the morning.
I'll be gone in the morning. All my friends are sitting over there. I'm going to go upstairs and use the bathroom.
When are you leaving?
Tomorrow morning.
As soon as possible?
Probably like 9. What time will you be up yet?
Yeah. Well, I doubt it.
Well, you can come over and say, if you're up, knock on the door. Say bye.
2:53?
Yeah, we're like 2 doors down. Yeah. I knocked on your door earlier. I don't know.
Oh, we don't all kinds of
I'm sure you weren't even there, actually.
Okay. Yeah.
It was way earlier.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, I'll see you. Yeah.
Excuse me.
No, don't leave.
What's your face going in there, dude?
Janis Joplin. Janis Joplin, the man, dude.
That's so great. Come on,
huh?
It's still there, right?
That
getting all the chicks over there dancing in Savannah. Like, what are we filming at?
Background. Background.
You ever hear the remix of this where they throw Fresh Prince over it? Now this is a story all about how my life got Let's go this way.
is it?
My spell, yeah.
I got it.
Okay. Awesome. At least you got the one song. I got it on. I got some of it. Yeah.
I know.
I'll look at them.
Oh, sure. Everything.
What's our time?
It's bad.
She said,
What, where'd you guys go?
We went on a few paces to the car.
Oh, okay.
Get a few
items. Oh, there, you gotta recharge your phone, right?
Right.
Okay.
Huh.
Would you think
right.
that pizza best one to fall asleep to
tag them on Facebook?
What's up, sir? Shh. No, don't fight. Go back to sleep. Your eyes are getting heavy.
There certainly still is poverty.
Making me tired.
These tapes you got.
Yeah, you haven't seen them yet, have you?
Yeah.
Can I record your awesomeness?
Yeah,
it's
the audio. I don't like talking. I mean, you know, I don't like being on camera. I fucking hate it. It's uncomfortable. You can look at it.
I saw
them
just walking around.
Yeah. Then go for it.
Alright.
They for sale now.
Black Magic Terror.
Oh, okay.
These are all French Canadian tapes. That's Donnie's. I don't know what this is. It's Liar's Moon. I'm not sure what it is. There's a few of them I'm not sure. I have to watch them. It's Two of the Apocalypse.
Or you can play these in your...
Yeah, they're Canadian.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's from
Quebec. Okay.
Yeah. I don't know what this one is either. But we'll see. This one, no one has. I have, like, ideas what they are, but I'm not sure. This one, no one has any idea. And there's this one of the Canadian people that are here from Quebec. She was like, I have...
Did you get all these from them?
Yeah, I got these all from Tony. He didn't know what these were. Like, she read it, and she said that's, like, broken French, and it doesn't make sense. And these titles, this movie titles, we're going on. This is the, I'll leave this one for last because it's the coolest. Actually,
okay.
These two are the coolest ones. There's this one. I think it's one of the Jaws ripoffs.
Cool.
This one's really. What was this one? I think it's one of the Jaws ripoffs. Yeah, Vic Morrow. This one, this is the one everyone's liking the most, but it's actually my least favorite. It's The Burning, French Canadian.
Oh,
the cover is really cool.
I don't really like The Burning that much.
There's this one. I love The Burning, I just don't really care about the
That's cool.
Yeah, French Canadian bass is enough too. And this one has a fake cover. It's kind of with alligators, so that's
cool.
I have two cameras on me. I'm going to be famous.
Hey, Lewis, tell me a Wasteland story.
I'm tired.
Wrestling.
Well, I saw wrestling, and a guy got hit the dick with a ladder.
There's nothing like getting hit in the dick with a ladder.
And I got French Canadian tape. And just since you're here.
Son of a bitch. I have like a dozen tapes from around the world of that, but I do not have that.
I was the one that showed you this tape.
You gave me like a cut box version of that. No, you didn't. You had a cut box version of that.
Now he will give you a cut.
No, it's signed to me. If you want one, this is to Lewis.
Sure. No.
I gave you Anthropophagus cut box.
Yes.
A French CIC. Last House on the Left, which I now found out how much it's worth. I'm like,
I have one of those.
The French Canadian big box?
Oh.
Clamshell?
Clamshell, yeah.
It's in French.
Oh, no, it's not French.
The what?
No.
How does it work? Tony sold one for $400.
I feel bad.
That's water power money. That's how much that...
360.
Yeah.
I wanted that tape. My buddy said he wanted it, so I didn't join on it.
Oh, you know who won it?
No. It went out of
here.
Oh, this was the
right.
This was the one I didn't know existed until Tony randomly found it. It's like French Canadian.
That's awesome.
Because I like French Canadian tapes because there's like there has to be like less than 300 of them. Because Quebec's not, there's only like a million people there. So that's not a lot of interest.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Awesome.
It's killing me because this poster is, I don't know what the fuck it is, and nothing makes sense, and I don't like my life anymore.
Did you buy these or trade for them?
Oh.
What?
I said both.
I thought you said theft.
Beat the fuck out of Tony Smith. Yeah, these are way too much.
Huh?
Lots of like retail, like 400 men.
Oh, do you have a fun weekend?
Sleep.
Oh, sleep. I was close. I said electric.
That's the cable, there's the shore.
Ah! Why are you fucking cable?
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm just saying, you like that sound?
It's part of the song!
Yeah?
That's totally how they recorded it. It's techno.
Ordinary grass.
When it came out, I'm like, this sounds like Nirvana, Josh.
Yeah.
But it's like, hey, it kind of does, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I'm like, is this Nirvana?
Is it grindy?
Oh, dude, it's fucking like...
Cool, that'd be cool.
Yeah, it's that kind of screaming, but...
That'd be awesome. Nice, I got it. Oh.
Bitch talking shit.
See, I'm a nice guy, and I pick shit up. All right, we gotta go.
Oh, we gotta go down this way, yeah.
See, I'm a nice guy, and I knock over bitches, I apologize.
Here, what's this? Boober.
Breathers!
Boober.
Broogies.
Thank you.
Somebody should, call the zoo because somebody let the pythons out of their cage.
Someone looking for somebody strong?
About as bad as mine.
Lori, does this look bad?
No, why?
I'm trying to pull up some ass.
Oh.
In the morning, we like to do karate. Yeah. Call this one the Weaver.
The Weaver?
You can't shame Tita. Cheetah.
I'm the most mature man there is, because when I try to take myself serious, it gets serious. That's all I'm going to say. So if you guys need any help from a serious, mature man, hit me up.
Maturity.
Maturity.
Maternity.
We're getting pregnant.